Today, once again, I'm coming to you from Country Classic Cars here in Staunton, Illinois. And Jordan actually just pointed this one out to me. It's not a truck I would probably think to look at first, but it is kind of interesting. This is actually a 1984 Ford Ranger. And you can see they got a little flatbed on the back there. But what's pretty unique about this one is that somebody's actually swapped in a 302 V8 backed by an AOD automatic. So it's kind of a little bit of a sleeper. So let me go ahead and check it out here. And it's a nice solid truck. You can see it's got nice chrome up front here. And sorry, it's a little dark back in the corner here today. It's a gloomy day. Got some aftermarket progressive aluminum wheels. And they do kind of tip you off here with the 5.0 badges on the fenders. And that was kind of a common swap back in the day. Saw that in a lot of magazines at the time. People swapping Mustang V8s into these things. And it does make for a pretty quick truck. You can see it's got a flatbed, some little homemade stake sides on here. And they have a wooden toolbox back here you can store all your stuff in. Or like I told Jordan, it'd be really great for mounting nitrous bottles. And then you could really surprise people. Guys, actually Jordan just opened up what I said was a toolbox and we saw that it does actually have a fuel cell in there. That's an old racing style fuel cell, like you'd find in like a dirt track car, that kind
of
thing.
I bet it came out of a dirt track car.
From around here, it's most likely, yeah. I would think. But there is a little room where you could throw some tools in there. Personally, I'd probably move it over and then put the nitrous bottle right here.
I kind of like this thing.
It's interesting. It would surprise the heck out of some people with a little bit of work, you know?
I just like how much character it has. Yeah. It's a very neat little truck.
How fun would it be to... I'm just assuming it's... somewhat mild, but I don't know that. But how much fun would it be to put a big, huge cam in that 302? And you see it's got dual exhaust coming out the back panel here. It almost looks like the through-hole exhaust on a boat, the way it's coming out of there. But I bet it sounds pretty good. And they've got some homemade mud flaps that they made out of, looks like dirt track tires. Interesting. It does have traction bars on it, on the leaves. Sliding rear window. Yeah. But pretty cool truck. Let's see if we can take a peek inside here. I probably should get my cell phone out, maybe get a little light on the situation here. And of course we're going to take a look under the hood. The truck's in really nice shape. Nice tall back bucket seats with a console. Little aftermarket wheel, like probably a Grant wheel. And you can see there's a shift light on the column. Some aftermarket gauges there in the center. And it's got a Z-gate shifter on that automatic. The tach's mounted right there on the dashboard. And you can see a little stick on plaques there from various shows and things. But let me see if I can get the hood open and we'll take a look under there. But you can see it's pretty interesting under here. Got that 302 in there. It does have an aluminum intake and a 4-barrel Edelbrock carburetor. Some nice headers on there as well. And obviously it's got the nice thin aluminum valve covers and air cleaner. Pretty interesting. And then this guy obviously takes it to a lot of cruise nights and shows. So he's got all the little plaques here.
It's actually kind of neat.
Mm-hmm.
They had this thing all over, basically all of the shows in Illinois he went to.
Mm-hmm.
That's at SWIC.
And then it looks like he's got a adjustable proportioning valve on the brakes there. I assume disc brakes up front, probably drums in the back. But I would imagine, I mean, a 4-barrel aluminum intake, headers. This thing's got to scoot down the road pretty well, I would think.
Yeah, it's not like Rangers are particularly heavy either. Uh-oh. It's a neat car. I like that they did all this. It makes it more interesting.
It's kind of neat. You wouldn't expect it, you know. Here, let's go ahead and check out the specs on it. Once again, it's 1984 Ford Ranger. 302 V8, AOD automatic, which means it has overdrive, which is nice. Less than 10,000 miles on the build. And runs and drives, $7,950. But anyway, guys, Jordan just came across this back here in the corner and I thought you might like taking a look at it. It's just something unusual. I mean, even when you see sort of the few little custom touches, you wouldn't really expect it to have a V8 in it. And I'm sure it runs out really strong. But as always, we do appreciate you watching and commenting. And if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to our channel, and we'll have many more videos on the way soon. Thanks again. Bye.